Hello, everybody. Adam Dorfman here, and today we're going to talk about one of my favorite subjects, and that subject is time management. As I speak to people, as I travel, as I'm at conferences, as I'm asked questions, one of the most frequent questions I get from people is, how do you balance everything? How do you balance running a successful organization, running a business, being a father, being a husband, being a friend, spending time with your family, doing fun things that you want to do? So as I have these conversations, what people are consistently asking is, how do I have a balanced life? Where do you find work-life balance? But the more I dig into these conversations, the more questions I ask, what I realize they're actually asking is not about how to have a balanced life, because it's not what they want. They want to have an unbalanced life. So I'm going to explain what I mean by that, and then we're going to talk a little bit about how to reframe our thought around life balance, okay? So first things first, we've got to recognize that pretty much everything we do in life is broken into three categories. Category one is sleep. I don't care who you are, I don't care how great you are, I don't care how smart you are, you gotta sleep, right? No matter what, you gotta sleep. Number two is work. Number three is recreation. So pretty much everything falls into the category of sleep, of work, of recreation, okay? So let's talk about sleep. We wanna sleep an average, most people, 8 hours a day, 7 days a week. That's 56 hours of sleep a week. Now, I know some people, they say they need, you know, 7 hours or 6 hours. Some people are like, oh yeah, I just need 4 hours of sleep a night. Well, scientifically, that's incorrect. Maybe you can get by with five or six. Maybe some people will power nap throughout the day. But no matter what, when you add up the sleep, minimum we need seven. But for the sake of this conversation, we're going to say 8 hours a day, okay? Now, what most people want to do is they want to work 40 hours. They want to work 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, which is a 40-hour week, okay? And then they want to recreate. Obviously, they need their 8 hours of recreation, but they need it 7 days a week. That's 56 hours, but wait, they don't work on weekends, so that's another 16 hours. So that's actually 72 hours of recreation, 40 hours of work, and 56 hours of sleep, and what would be considered the normal American balanced life, right? So as we're looking at this, and people tell me that they really want to be successful, and they really need this work-life balance, I take a step back and I say, do you really need 72 hours a week of recreation? I don't even know what I would do with myself, especially when I was in my 20s, or I was single with 72 hours of recreation. I feel like I would, you know, either spend a ton of money or make a bunch of bad decisions and end up in a bad situation, right? So my way to reframe this for myself was, I feel like there's this mindset where you gotta pay now or pay later, but eventually you have to pay. So for me, I don't want a balanced life. I want a remarkably unbalanced life in the sense that I'm able to sleep when I need to sleep, work some, but pretty much do whatever I want to do when I want to do it. But the only way to do that is you've got to make the investment of time early in your career. So the way that I reframed this for myself was, what if we actually do have a balanced life? What if instead of doing it this way, you do what you say you want, which is you'd have a 56 hours of sleep, you got 56 hours of work, and you have 56 hours of recreation. So what that works out to, maybe you're not working 7 days a week. I think everybody should take one full day every week off to recharge, relax, refresh. And maybe instead of 8 hour days, maybe you put in 10. Maybe you put in a little bit of extra time studying, time reading, time watching TED Talks, time looking at books, time having conversations with mentors and people who can help you. So when I say work, I don't mean doing your job 56 hours a week. I mean investing into yourself 56 hours a week, doing things that make you money and doing things that help you gain knowledge and experience to become better. Because if you do this, you're working 16 hours a week more than the average American. That's 40% more effort than the average person. And if you're able to put that time in early in your career, you're gonna get that time back with interest later on. So if your mindset is pay now to play later, balance your life now, equal work, sleep, and recreation, and you'll be able to have an unbalanced life in favor of the things you want to do later in life. Thank you for watching. If this was helpful, please share it, please pass it along, please forward it, and please leave some comments below. Have a great day.